Hello dear student, I am Lakshmikant Kapgate. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, and today I am going to focus on the punctuation parts that comes under writing skill. So writing skill is a very important skill that everyone should know about its qualities and the tenets also. So let us see and try to understand what is comma and how to use and when we should not use comma, right? So if you are new to my YouTube channel, let's learn to shine. You can subscribe or you can hit the subscribe button and you can get the latest notification of the uploaded video in coming future. So let us understand what is comma. Dear student, everyone knows that what is comma and how to use comma, right? So we use all these commas or you know, commas every day whenever we write anything, when any essays, any composition, any answer in our question in our exam. But did you know that there are plenty of common mistakes that people make when using a comma in writing in a sentence, right? Sometimes we use them when they are not necessary, and sometimes we use them when they are very much necessary. We are not, right? So this video will guide you, will tell you how to use comma. But before that, let us understand what is comma. So comma is a punctuation mark, and it denotes a pause in a sentence which is shorter than colon and semicolon, right? And when we understand comma, we always find that it connects two parts of a sentence, or else or that can separates the items in a list. So commas are generally used to make a piece of text more user friendly or the reader friendly, as without them a reader may be overwhelmed by the sheer volume of uninterrupted text, right? So this comma is used to show the difference between two separate ideas or elements within a sentence. And commas have other uses as well. For example, we can use this comma to separate the numbers, to separate the dates, to separate the address and the years too, right? So before going into the details, we must understand what is British, or what is the difference between American and the British English use of comma, right? So in this context, we can understand that the serial comma, that is also known as the Oxford comma. What is why this is Oxford comma? Because Oxford comma is traditionally used by the Oxford University press publishers or the writers or the people those they are working in that category. But not all the people have used this Oxford comma, right? Basically, the major difference between the American and the British English and the use of comma is with the serial comma. As I already said, the Oxford comma, right? So in the US, in the United States, the serial commas are most often used in all lists, no matter what. Okay. And in the United Kingdom, means in British or in British English, the Oxford commas are only used when the meaning of the item in the list would be unclear. So here you can see the examples on the screen. In the US, serial commas are most often with the all list. For example, I am going to pick bananas, grapes, apples, and pears. So in this sentence, you can see the comma is already used with apple. Okay. And in the British English, however, the Oxford commas are only used when the meaning of the items in the list would be unclear. Okay. To separate the meaning or to clear the meaning. Otherwise, if we are not using these commas, the reader of this paragraph or any answer or any composition may get confused. So in British English, we can write like this. I am going to pick bananas, grapes, apple, and pears. So I removed or I remove this comma after apple that has been used in the first sentence, right? So this is the little bit, or this is the slightest difference between the American and the British English. Okay, now see another important thing that we can understand. So in this slide, you can see there are 13 situations. There are 13 situation or the context in which we can use comma, and maybe these are the rules for you that you can keep in your mind or you can remember in your life, right? So the key things to remember about commas in a sentence is that they should be used to break the clause. And linking a subordinated clause that makes a little sense without the main clause. And should always be done with a comma to show that the two ideas are linked. Okay. If you use your subordinate clause within the middle of a main clause, then you ought to use two commas. Okay. So these things you must remember while understanding or while, you know, keeping the rules in me about commas. So let us see, there are certain situations we use comma to separate a series of words, to separate a series of phrases, to connect the two independent clauses, to set of introductory phrases and clauses used after certain words that introduce a sentence, to separate the parenthetical elements, to separate the coordinate adjectives, to separate the quoted phrase parts, to set up phrases to express contrast. We always use commas to avoid the confusion, to set up expression that interrupts the sentence flow, right? To interrupt or to break the flow of ideas, we can use commas to separate. I already said that we can use comma to separate the dates, years, addresses, and we always use this comma to separate the statement from a question tag or the question tag question, you can say, right? So let us see one by one. So to separate a series of words, so we use commas between the series, right? Or in a series. And here you must notice that a comma does not follow the last word in a series. So in the first situation, for example, he was tall, comma, dark, comma, and handsome. American English. Okay. So he was tall, comma, dark, comma, and handsome. Okay. If you are writing in British English, you just remove that comma that has been used after dark. Okay. Another example I can tell you that, do you want some cakes, candies, or ice cream? Okay. The second situation is to separate a series of phrases. For example, we always use phrases while talking about any situation or about our interest. I like reading books, listening to music, watching TVs, and studying English. So there are phrases has been used in the sentence. We can use also to connect the two independent clauses. For example, I was feeling hungry, comma, so I made myself a sandwich. Another example you can understand. Although she is very poor, comma, she has not lost her dignity. Okay. So this is how you can understand. The next situation is we can use comma to set up the introductory phrases or clauses. How? So we can use a comma to separate an introductory elements from the rest of the sentence. For example, as the day come to an end, the firefighters put out the last spark. Okay, so comma is used after end. As the day come to an end, I have used, means there is a break. Okay, there is a pause and introductory phrases or a clause, you can say, that is break by or broken by with the aid of comma. We can also use in certain certain words that introduce a sentence. When we use, this situation appears when we communicate with our friends. For example, well, I'm okay. Well, I'm not going to going home on foot at any rate. Okay. Hey, don't tell me what you do. Or what to do. Yes, I will be there. Okay, so these are the situation that in that situation you can use comma. We can use this comma to separate the parenthetical elements. What is parenthetical elements? A parenthetical elements and add extra information and can be removed from the sentence without changing the meaning of a sentence. For example, my grandmother, comma, old and sick, comma, never goes out of the house, right? So in this situation, I have used two commas, my grandmother, comma, old and sick, right? So these are the parenthetical elements. For example, another example I can tell you, football, comma, which is a popular sport, comma, is very good for health. Okay. We can also use these commas to coordinate adjectives. So in a single sentence, we can add adjective about any person. So he is competent, comma, efficient worker, and very energetic too. Right? Another example you can take. The followers feel energetic, comma, confident, and happy. So, did you get my point? Another interesting thing that in the narration part, or when we go and understand the indirect or direct speech, that time you can use to quote the direct statement of any person. So Shakespeare said, do you want to learn English? Do you want to come with me? Do you want to enjoy a coffee with me? Likewise, you can say. So he asked, they said, Shakespeare said, William, Wordsworth said, likewise, we can use. So after said, you can use comma. Again, we can set up the phrases to express the contrast. Means to express the contrast or the, you can say different situation in the same sentence, you can use. For example, we always use commas to set up the contrasting expression beginning with not. Okay. So let us see. Many people says that, one of my friends said that ki paisa khuda nahi hota, but khuda se kam bhi nahi hota. There is a contrast. So in English, we can say money is a good servant, but not a bad, sorry, but a bad master. Okay. The golden age is before us, not behind us. Adversity make a man wise, right? Adversity makes a man wise, not rich. Okay. So you can use the comma before but, before not, before, not, that negative words. Okay. We always use comma to avoid the confusion for the readers. We always use commas to avoid the confusion. When someone is writing, reading your paragraph, your answer, he can or he must learn easily, right? So that time we can use commas, right? For example, I saw she was busy. I saw that she was busy, comma, and prepared to leave. Okay. The second sentence is, for most, the year is already finished. The year is already finished. So these are the two sentences that you can understand in which we can use comma to avoid the confusion. Okay. Then another situation is that to set off expression that interrupts the sentence flow. So we can use comma to break the flow of ideas, to break the opinion, to break the ideas that we communicate through our writings, right? For example, on the other hand, therefore, so, otherwise, in a nutshell, these are the words that we can use to break the flow of our ideas. Okay. So as I already said that we can use comma to separate the dates, years, addresses. Okay. Then to separate the sentence or the statement from a tag question. What is the meaning of tag question? I will tell you an example. You are not moving, or you are moving to London, aren't you? Okay. So let us take the next bus, shall we? There is nothing wrong, is there? So these are the questions that you can understand with the help of commas. Okay. Then the next thing is that you must, now I'm going to tell you that these, there are some, or there are three situations. In that particular situation, you must not use commas. For example, when there are two only items in a list, in a sentence are mentioned, that time you must not use comma before and. Okay, let us see the example. From the show, from the store, I just need to pick up lipstick, comma, and eyeshadow. Now see, the comma is used after lipstick. This is incorrect. So the correct sentence will be like this. From the store, I just need to pick up the lipstick and eyeshadow, right? So here what happened, we must notice that the first comma remains, right? The first comma remains. That is because from the store is an introductory phrase, and that is a subordinate clause. And because it makes no sense without the rest of the sentence, so a comma is necessary here, but not to separate the two items in the list. Okay. Take the another situation. We must not use comma when the two actions relate to one subject. What is subjects? Subject is I in the sentence. So I walked home through the park and sang along to my music. So the same subject is doing two different things in the same sentence, right? So if there are two actions that both relates to the same subjects of a sentence, then a comma is unnecessary. However, many people make or still make mistake in this situation. So the correct sentence like this: I walked home through the park and sang along to my music. Okay. Another one is, you must not use a comma when or after the last item in the list. Let's see the that mistake we always make in the first sentence. Amita, Sita, and Gita. Now see, after Gita there is a comma. Amita, Sita, and Gita were terrified the moment they stepped inside. Now see what happened in this sentence. If a list is given and then the sentence continues after the list, people are tempted to place a comma after the last item, right? So this is, however, a mistake and a very common one that one at this situation, right? So here the correct sentence will be like this: Amita, Sita, and Gita. So I have removed this comma after that we have already used in the first sentence. After Gita were terrified the moment they stepped inside, right? So the problem with the mistake is that the pausing after Gita, right, where the comma is somewhat natural, right? So when reading back your back to your work to identify the mistake, it may be difficult. Just remember that a comma is never necessary before the first item in a list or after the last item in the list, right? So this is how we can write: Amita, Sita, and Gita were terrified the moment that stepped inside, right? So I hope, my dear student, you understood the use of comma and the common rules or the common mistake that we use while using comma in our writing, right? So thanks for watching my video, and again I'm going to request you that you must subscribe my channel so that you can get the link of new videos. Thank you.